Windows OEM versions. You may have seen it before, maybe you've even bought a copy or two. I have a version of Windows 11 OEM right here. But what actually is the difference? I've seen a lot of talk online that has some theories, like you don't get support with Windows OEM and the manufacturer has to do it. But it turns out that that seems to not really be the case. There's not as big of a difference as you might think, but it's a bit more nuanced than that. That's what we're gonna talk about. Now, the first thing to understand is that Windows OEM, which stands for Original Equipment Manufacturer, is not actually an edition of Windows. It's a type of license for Windows. There's OEM versions of all the editions of Windows, Pro, Home, whatever. And this is opposed to the retail version of the license, also called the full packaged product, if you're being technical. And if you're wondering right off the bat whether or not your version of Windows is OEM or retail, you can actually use a command in the command prompt to show this. If you type in SLMGR space slash DLI, it will pop up this little thing. It'll say the name of the edition of Windows. In my case, it's Professional for Workstations. And in the description, you can see mine says Retail Channel, for example. Now, if you have an OEM version of Windows, that likely means that you bought a pre-built computer, like most people do. The OEM versions of Windows basically just means that it's not sold directly to the consumer. Like you'd go to, I don't know, Staples or Newegg and buy like the Windows box, if they're even in a box anymore. That's like the retail copy. And then the OEM version is meant to be for system builders who like actually build the computers and then they put that on the computer. However, you can still, if you're building your own computer, buy an OEM version as well. That's what I did. And it's usually a bit cheaper. That's one of the differences. So why don't we go over some of the other differences, including that. So what are these differences? Well, first of all, if you buy the OEM version of Windows, it's not gonna come in a nice box. It's gonna come in like a basic sleeve looking like this, because it's not really meant to be bought by a consumer. It's meant to be bought in bulk. So the packaging is not exactly a priority. We'll take a closer look at this though later. The wording and stuff on the outside is actually important. Also, the OEM version is gonna be cheaper. If you look at the Newegg pricing, and these are actually sold by Newegg, so it's not a third party seller, you can see that the retail version of Windows 11 Home is $139, whereas the OEM is actually $120 or $130. Strangely, the physical version is actually $10 cheaper than the digital. I don't know why that is. It's the same thing for the Pro version of Windows 11 retail. That's $200. And the OEM Pro is $160 or $170, depending on whether it's physical or digital. Now, will it have any less bloatware? Not really. It's actually the exact same contents of the installation disk. Now, you might get a different version of the installation in terms of OEM if like you get it from a manufacturer like Dell or Asus or something. They might actually give you an OEM disk that installs an OEM version of Windows, but it's like plus all their stuff that they add into it. So it's not like a clean OEM version. If you just go and buy directly a blank OEM disk, it's gonna be exactly the same as if you bought it retail in terms of what actually comes with it. So the OEM version doesn't inherently have any less bloatware or more. That's also why if you do buy a pre-built computer or a laptop or something, it usually comes with a branded copy of the Windows installer disk. And again, that comes with any proprietary special drivers or something, or just special bloatware that is specific for that brand on that computer. Another significant difference that does seem to be the case is that you're more restricted in transferring the license or the installation from one computer to another. So with the retail version, it seems like if you basically wipe the computer, you can move that license key to another computer as long as you stop using it on the other one. Whereas with OEM, it's basically tied to that specific hardware, the motherboard in particular. So you might have a hard time moving it. You might be able to get it to work, but technically you're not really supposed to. And finally, the big difference that I've seen a lot of people say, and if you go online and search what's the difference between OEM and retail versions of Windows, this is the one you're always gonna see, and that is that with OEM, you don't get support from Microsoft. But I was wondering about that because I couldn't actually find any official page on any of Microsoft's websites or even on their support pages that mentioned OEM. So I'm like, is this one of those things that just so many people have said it that everyone just believes it, or is it not true at all maybe? Before that though, something that unfortunately is easy to find online is all your personal data, which is where today's sponsor comes in, Aura. Sketchy data brokers out there collect and sell your information to scammers, spammers, and anyone else who may want to target you. I'm talking your full name, email, home address, health records, your relatives, it's all out there. But that's where Aura comes in. For example, it can show me which data brokers are selling my info and automatically submit opt-out requests for me. Cleaning up this info not only helps me reduce the amount of spam coming my way, but also protects me from hackers who might leverage this info to try and access my accounts or even do personalized phishing attacks. I was even surprised when it showed me that the collected public info out there even includes what kind of car I drive. But Aura also has a ton of other features, such as antivirus, a VPN, password management, parental controls, identity theft insurance, all in one place instead of needing a bunch of separate apps. Even if you already have one or two of these tools, you could still be leaving doors open to bad actors, but Aura is always on, so you can have peace of mind and focus on the other important stuff. To get started, you can go to aura.com/theojo to start your 2-week free trial. Link is also in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. Okay, so is it actually true that you don't get support with the OEM version of Windows? And I was actually interested because I usually do buy the OEM version because I never contact Microsoft support. Because the way I see it, if I can't figure something out myself from looking it up online, asking questions, and that sort of thing, there's no way that any customer support rep is gonna be able to help me any more than that. And they're probably just gonna end up recommending to reset the PC, which is effectively like reformatting it, which is probably what I would do anyway. So I don't need Windows support. But you might be wondering, wait a minute, what is Windows support? Have many of you even ever thought to contact Windows Microsoft support with a problem with your computer? But actually, Microsoft does have direct support that you can access. One way is through the Get Help app. I believe it's pre-installed in Windows 11 at least. And I actually was like, well, you know what, let's try it out. I'll go on here and ask the customer service rep, what is the difference between the OEM and the retail? So you basically just put in a question and then you can click the contact support and there's a few options for dropdown and then it connects you. It actually opens up a website, like a chat window. And I simply asked, what's the difference between OEM and retail? He gave me the first canned response talking about, oh, it's for device manufacturers, blah, 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 but I wanted to know the difference. I said something like, I heard that there's a difference in support. And then he actually got back to me and said that, no, there's actually no difference in support. You can still get support if you have an OEM version. Now, again, I didn't know if that was 100% accurate. That might just be something that they say automatically, but I don't think that they have some checker on their end of the system, or I don't think the app checks, oh, well, you're not allowed to contact support because you have an OEM version. I mean, imagine if that was a thing where the Get Help app, which is pre-installed in Windows, if you try to run it, and most people do have an OEM version if they bought a computer pre-built from a manufacturer, and most people can't even use the app and it tells them they can't, I don't see that as happening. So I was like, there's something not lining up with what everyone is saying in terms of not being able to get support and the reality that I'm seeing. So I was searching all over like Microsoft's help pages and any licenses I could find talking about support specifically, and I really came down to two main documents. One is the one that's actually built into Windows. It's in the license.rtf file in the system directory. We're gonna look at that in a second, it's very relevant. And then there is actually the OEM license, which funny enough is right on the card or envelope that you get when you buy the OEM version. The license is right here. And I could not actually find this online. Like, it's only on here. You can technically sign up to be a device partner with Microsoft, but that's a whole thing. And I think you actually have to be a legit company to do that. So it's not really public, but this is right here anyway, so it didn't really matter. Anyway, if we do go and look at the license files that come with Windows, you have one on your computer right now, of course. You probably agreed to it at some point without remembering it, but there it is. Anyway, it's gonna appear in several places. So one is right in the system32 directory. It's called license.rtf, and also several other places in there in subdirectories. So also in system32/licenses, there's a directory with some stuff we can look at, and then system32/enus, or whatever language you're using, and then licenses. And I noticed in the licenses folder, the higher level one, it just has a folder called neutral. And then within there, there were three folders called default, OEM, and volume. And interestingly, the English US/licenses directory seems to have the same folder structure. It's like exactly the same stuff. Now, the one that talks about Windows IoT Enterprise, that's for like Internet of Things devices. That's irrelevant here. There's also one for volume pricing, but you open that up, it's not actually a license. It just basically says you're bound by licenses that are not here, that sort of thing. But I was interested in comparing the license files in the default directory, the OEM directory, and then the one just in System32. And it turns out the license.rtf file in all of those locations are literally the exact same file. They have the same hash, they're not different. So it seems like, at least for the Windows license, which is a totally separate thing from the OEM license, the Windows license is universal. There's not like a different one that applies to you compared to whether you have OEM or retail. All right, now I'm sure you're all thinking, all right, yeah, we get it. Come on, get to the good part. Let's actually look at this. So let's open up the Windows agreement thing that's actually in your computer that you could probably see right now. Anyway, there's two main sections that are very relevant to the questions we have about getting support. One of them literally is in a section called support. And here we can read, there's actually two possible scenarios that it lists out. One says for software pre-installed on a device, and the other one is for software acquired from a retailer. And clearly this is talking about an OEM version versus a retail version. But let's take a closer look. So the first one, it says, for the software generally, contact the device manufacturer or installer for support options. Refer to the support number provided with the software. For updates and supplements obtained directly from Microsoft, Microsoft may provide limited support services for properly licensed software as described at, you know, Microsoft's general support page. Okay, so how does that differ from a retail copy? It just says, Microsoft provides limited support services for properly licensed software as described. Same as the ending of the other one. So both of them actually say that Microsoft might provide support, limited support, except the OEM one just has that extra thing talking about contacting them for support first. However, note that even in the OEM version, it talks about for updates and supplements provided directly from Microsoft, but you could argue that Windows is updated so frequently, and I mean, every year there's a major update, that pretty much then qualifies you to receive support directly from Microsoft, because you got an update, so therefore you want support. So it seems like, realistically, Microsoft is just kind of forcing retailers to provide support for the product, but it doesn't like exclude you from getting support from Microsoft, if that makes sense. And we'll take a look more at that later. But there is one other section at the beginning we need to take a look at, and that's at the top of the agreement. And notice how it says, depending on how you obtained the Windows software, this is a license agreement between one, you and the device manufacturer or software installer that distributes the software with the device, or two, you and Microsoft Corporation if you acquire the software from a retailer. So reading that, you might think, well, wait a minute, if I even buy an OEM copy, it doesn't say that here, then I bought it from Newegg or Amazon. That means that, yeah, even though it's OEM, I still bought it from a retailer, therefore I qualify for condition B. But turns out that's not actually the case. We need to look at the OEM license on the OEM package to see why. So like I briefly showed you before, if you buy an OEM disc, it's gonna look slightly different. It's gonna look like this ugly packaging, and there's like two sleeves in it. There's this outer sleeve, which has stuff talking basically to a manufacturer, and then there's an inner sleeve. Let's look at the inner one first, and you'll notice that it has a sticker on it that goes on the PC, and it has instructions saying stuff like, for product support, contact the manufacturer of your PC. And you can also notice that the disc that it comes with also specifically says, intended for distribution with a new PC, for product support, contact manufacturer of your PC. So they're really laying it on thick that you're supposed to get support from the manufacturer. And I think this is why that whole myth of you can only get support from the manufacturer comes from if you get an OEM, because they really try to make it seem that way. But let's move back to the outer sleeve, and here, the language is all addressing the manufacturer instead. And again, here it says, you are responsible for providing end user support. But here is the important bit. You'll notice that there's like a red sticker and it says, warning, if you're a system builder, by opening this package, you agree that you have read and understood the Microsoft OEM System Builder license affixed to this package and agree to the terms and conditions. So going back to what I was hinting at before in the Windows license agreement, even though it says, yeah, if you buy it from a retailer, then condition B applies. Well, that can also be true at the same time as you now agreed to this, where you agreed to give your own support. Anyway, let's take a look at the backside that has the actual OEM license that everyone's talking about. And turns out the proper name is the Microsoft OEM System Builder License. Again, in there, number 7, it says, end user support. you must provide end-user support for the software. Interestingly, it also adds, at a minimum, you'll provide commercially reasonable telephone support. And I'll just put the rest of it on the screen if you want to, you know, pause it and read through it yourself. But I want you to consider something. Yes, it says all over the place that the manufacturer is going to have to provide support for the customer. But does it actually say anywhere that Microsoft will not provide support to the customer directly? I don't see that anywhere. Obviously, they all over the place try to convince people to go to the manufacturer first, but again, they're not preventing you from doing so. Now, if you really wanted to be technical, I think you could reasonably argue that, yeah, technically Microsoft could turn away supporting people who have an OEM license, but I've never actually seen evidence of this happening. So at the end of the day, I think really the only difference between the OEM copy, if you decide to buy that, and a retail version is, one, gonna be the price, it's gonna be a little bit cheaper. You might not be able to get support theoretically, but I don't think in practicality. I think you'll have no problem actually getting support. But probably the main other practical difference is it might be hard to transfer it from one computer to another if you ever decide to do that. So if you were worried, well, oh, I have a Windows OEM version, or you're buying an OEM version, you're trying to save a few bucks, I don't think you're really missing out on anything. However, I would be very interested to know what you guys think down in the comments. Maybe you have totally different experience. Maybe there is the rare case where actually it does make a difference that I did not think of. So we can talk about that down there. Also, thanks again to Aura for sponsoring the video. If you want to protect your data and take advantage of all the other features it has, go to aura.com/theojo for a 2-week free trial. Link in the description. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video and you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about one setting in Windows that I think everyone should enable that is not enabled by default. So I'll put that link right there you can click on. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.